One can do a definitely a low carb and even a ketogenic diet as a vegan vegetarian. It's easier to do it as a lacto-ovo vegetarian, where the majority of one's food is coming from non-meat sources, and particularly from plant sources. And I actually was participated in a symposium recently in Chicago where there was a advocate of total fasting for a duration of like 2 or 3 weeks followed by a plant-based diet, and he presented evidence of reversing type 2 diabetes with that approach. Mm-hmm. The total fasting was done in an inpatient setting. This is obviously would be a very expensive way of using this kind of therapy. And his data was impressive in terms of the people he selected to present. But these are people who chose to A, pay the money, and B, go through the fasting. And at the end, we agreed very collegial that there are some people who are well suited to do it that way. And there are many people, and certainly we found quite a few of them in the Lafayette, Indiana area who were able to do it with the Virta program. The two are not mutually exclusive. And so in the future, particularly as there are rigorous studies done with the plant-based diet, because up till now it's been more anecdotal and ideological than science-based, but as people demonstrate what percent of people who are recruited in such an intervention can succeed at that, at not just for months but for years, we'll be able to offer people basically a menu of options rather than saying this is the way to do it. And I don't think there's one carbon, you know, one cookie cutter approach that fits every human being's metabolic needs.
Yeah, and I also think there's preference and lifestyle choice too, is that you have to, we were talking about doing something sustainable, you have to choose something that's going to work for you both in terms of health and your metabolic needs and your lifestyle. So you have to kind of find the balance between the two, and for some people it might be one direction and for some people it might be a different direction.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Definitely have to consider what the patient's goals and values are.
Agreed.